Hi guys from Pax Europiana here from Vienna from the next pro-Ukrainian demonstration to stop Putin's war and also to protest against Austrian policy because we are unfortunately supporting Putin. Yeah, it's not just us, it's also the Germans, it's also the Hungarians. And by the way, I hope that Orban will lose tomorrow, and I hope that Vucic will lose tomorrow, and I hope that this government in Austria will also lose power because they have decided to support the Russian energy system. Wolfgang Schüssel is still the dominating person who is basically making Putin the lobby here. And the Austrians and the Germans, the Hungarians, this Putin axis is unfortunately very strong. They also logically support Vucic, who has also sold his energy sector and Serbia to Putin. And here from Vienna, I protest against all of this. Yeah, and I hope that the Viennese people will, and the Austrian people, the Serbs and the Hungarians and the Germans will vote against all these energy lobbyists from Russia, Schröder, Schüssel, Vucic, Orbán, who make this dirty business with the dirty carbon. That's absolutely a disaster. So I call, of course, for Ukraine to join the European Union. We had the launch of the EU37 campaign now at the Diplomatic Academy, together with Vienna Goes Europe. And it was very, very good start. I'm happy with that one. Of course, I had to explain as well that Serbia must be sanctioned and the EU candidate status must be clearly frozen, suspended, and the fast-track membership of Albania, Montenegro, Macedonia must also be done now by 2024. I've now written all the things I said the last years also in German, and I published it on my Substack and my podcast. I was able also to publish this big spending plan to fund all this integration of the 9 new countries and also how to rearm Europe. That was also a major success, and I'm trying to get more media coverage for my positions in the coming weeks and months here in Vienna, because Vienna should be in the heritage of Alois Mock, the country which is leading the campaign for EU37. Unfortunately, our guys here, they have sold out to Russia, and they must be punished for that. Because easy money, easy cheap energy, then they claim to be for climate change while bringing us billions of cubic meters of Russian gas additionally. I mean, this is really like a disaster policy. Yes, for Serbia, I have made my point going there. Thanks, Austrian Courier, for covering my visit and the negative reaction in the Serb media. Some politicians reacted and I was put on some online portal. I hope some people had the possibility to read what I say and criticize this very unfortunate pro-Russian pivot since 2003. Hungary is since 2010 with the Russians, and intensively, of course, the big things started in 2013, when Putin came in full force to massively enter Hungary again and Austria in 2014. That is, of course, all part of his strategy to change the European politics towards his direction. And in some countries he was successful. Also the Germans, they have actually three foreign policies now in the so-called Ampel. To my view, it's already morally completely bankrupt, and it should be immediately stopped and Jamaica be instituted. And in Austria, obviously, we need new elections. But unfortunately, Mrs. Social Democrat, would-be Chancellor, is also not able to really change the old socialist pro-Russian policy she always had, and this neutralist disaster policy. And Austria is one of the few countries which is still not invited Mr. Zelensky, President Zelensky, to the Austrian parliament. I'm working now to have Zelensky in the Kosovo parliament. I guess that will be happening before the Austrian parliament. That is a very powerful symbol for the complete disaster of the Austrian foreign policy under Schüssel, Schallenberg, Kurz, and all this unfortunate triad, and also unfortunately Mitterlehner. Yeah, all of them, unfortunately, have worked more with Russia than with the pro-Europeans. I still have to go to Alois Mock grave, to Eratsfeld, to tell him all this. And I will. I will for sure. Because he will turn in his grave to understand what they're all doing for money and for being trapped in their own electoral lies of the past. And now they are the lobbyists of Serbia, pro-Russian Serbia. Because I'm also for European Serbia, don't forget, never forget. I think few Austrians have worked more for European Serbia than me in the 90s and in the 2000s. But Putin won for now. He will lose now in Ukraine and he will lose also in Serbia and everywhere and one day even in Russia. Mark my words. So we have, of course, now this demonstration. I will be soon arriving. Keep you posted. This, by the way, is a wonderful Maria Hilfer Straße. Some of the people who watch my channel have seen it already. It's a very, very nice pedestrian area. It was full of traffic until recently, but then they changed that. And that was one of the prestige projects of the green side of the government. And that was very good. There are still some cars here, unfortunately. But I think only taxis or people who live in that area. But that is really, you see, it's booming. It's impressive. It's very beautiful. And it's the street, I remind everybody, where the emperor was driving from his two main assets, Schönbrunn, where he worked and lived in the winter, to his spring and autumn castle in Schönbrunn, also from Hofburg to Schönbrunn, to put it correctly. That is, was the Prunkstraße, the boulevard. For him, the city was designed for him, the emperor, obviously. That was the way. Vienna actually has a lot to offer. Wonderful place, great people, just the politics is a disaster. But must be changed, will be changed. I'm optimistic. Also, we will get free of Russian carbon. We will also join NATO. We will also be a normal European country one day. And if I made a lot of this podcast, maybe it goes a bit faster. So this, we are here in this beautiful city. It's very nice. And soon I will arrive and I will keep you posted. Here from Pax Europiana, from Vienna. There's a lot of civil society support for Ukraine now here, but obviously most important is to translate it into concrete membership perspective. And it was a clear yes to the EU membership of Ukraine now on Thursday. The deputy ambassador was there, the ambassador of Kosovo, also very good to see them sitting together on one panel, and also the ambassador of Albania. It was a very good event. And thanks for Vienna Goes Europe for organizing everything. And now, they will be also the key organizer of this event. And I'm very much looking forward for 2 hours calling for EU future of Ukraine. Yes. Thanks a lot for that. More to come from Pax Europiana here from Vienna. Bye.